Okay, folks, back with you at the Texas ACS 2017 State 8 Ball Championships. We're doing mixed scotch doubles today. And we are getting ready to stream our second match of the day. This is going to be Stacy Linerode and David Martinez versus Cardenas Olivo. And this is a one-loss side match. They're going to be playing a race to three. And players are all just warming up right now. That, I believe, is David Martinez racking the balls on the right side of your screen. Also on the left side of your screen, you have another Scotch doubles team warming up. That is Gomez Avila and Freer Smith. They're going to be going at it as well. I don't know much about these teams, but I do know that David Martinez and Stacy Linerode are from San Antonio, Texas. That's all I know. So we want to welcome you guys to the Texas ACS State 8 Ball Championships. And we also want to thank one of our sponsors, Bryant Billiards. And we want to remind you guys that without our sponsors, these events are not possible. So please go ahead and visit their websites and buy their stuff. Bryant Billiards. .com, Heather and Charlie Bryant. All right, so is this game one? Looks like it might be. She's really taking her time. So here we go. Game one. This is Stacy Linerode at the table. And one, two, three, four, five, six. Looks like her partner David broke and made a ball. Looks like they're taking stripes. Nice shot, actually. Left the cue ball. That 11 ball right there is the problem ball. And it looks like she's left David at a perfect angle to make that 11. Another problem ball might be the 13 ball as well. So let's see how he handles this. He looks like he's thinking hard. The only problem on this 11 is where to bring your cue ball. For what shot are you going to shoot next? Ooh, bump the 8 ball into another problem zone. And I don't think the 13 passes the 2. Well, to me, that was a questionable hit, but I'm not going to say anything to those guys. Nobody else called it. You guys think that was a good hit? So anyway, it looks like they've scratched. So here comes Cardenas Olivo. Taking out the six ball first. I believe this is Cardenas. Nancy. Oh, rattles the one ball. And it doesn't look like that 14 is going to be easy. So, Stacy Linerode looks like she can cut the 14 in this corner past the 3. But very difficult shot. Might be better to play a safety. She's calling the bank. Let's see if the banks are open. Wow, what a shot. I gotta give her that. That's just very good shot. Oh no! And such a good shot by Stacy, but David just couldn't handle the pressure. All right, so calling the one ball. I believe this is Olivo. And I don't have a first name either, so. I had to see her shirt. His shirt. Cutting the two ball in the corner. That cue ball's rolling. Oh boy. Left with a difficult combination or a difficult cut shot on the 7. I like the 7 ball, so. Nice shot. Where's the cue ball going? Oh no! That's going to be game one real quick. Taking ball in hand, Stacy will be licking her chops. And there we have it, game one. Stacy Linerode closes it out in this race to 3. I also want to thank OBQs for sponsoring the Texas ACS State 8 Ball Championships. And by the way, OBQs, after more than 2 years of research, are pleased to announce the DigiQ Blue Bluetooth-enabled billiard training device. It analyzes your stroke, and it sends detailed statistics to your smartphone or your mobile device. The brand new DigiQ Blue works with the DigiQ app, available for both iOS and Android devices. The original DigiQ was a huge success, and now they have followed up with the most requested feature, which is the ability to sync the device with a smartphone or a tablet. So check out obqs.com today and consider getting the DigiQ Blue device, stroke training device. And remember, if you buy a shaft, any shaft at OBQs, you get a free box of their OB chalk. Hi. Hey, what's up, Shannon? Want to check in with us? Yeah. Okay. All right. Good. Yup. There you go. All right. So, 1-0. There's David Martinez. Looks like they're shooting stripes. Good, man. Good. Thank you. Appreciate it. You want to commentate? I'll help you. I'm going to get some help here in the commentary booth. There you go. Put that on so it's comfortable. I'm going to get one of these Texas ACS members to come and help us out. How you doing, man?
What's going on? Lewis.
Lewis, my name is Daniel.
Nice to meet you.
And you're live on POV Pool. What's going on?
What's going on?
Hey, man, where are you from, first of all?
I'm from San Antonio, Texas.
San Antonio. So you know Stacy and David,
I know,
right?
Stacy, Dave, and John, and Nancy. John's actually my husband, actually.
Okay, so is John...
Olivo.
John Olivo. Mm-hmm. Okay, and so that's Nancy Cardenas.
Yes.
Yeah? Okay. All right, so you're rooting for John and Nancy.
I am rooting for John and Nancy,
okay.
Yes.
All right, it's 1-0.
It's 1-0, I know.
Pressure's on.
Pressure's on, because I would hate to drive home.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah. So, but you're all from San Antonio, so you all know each other.
No, plenty of people here. Yeah. Lots of people.
What's your
here.
Homeroom? You want to give it a shout out and all that?
I play out of San Antonio Pool League.
San Antonio Pool League, okay.
With Alberto Veronica Aguilar running the league.
All right. Ooh, look at this.
Oh,
in we got a drink. Yep.
Missed the ball, hit the ball, and then dropped.
Yup, that's going to be ball in hand.
Let's see, we got John coming up to the table. Let's see what he could do now.
Yup.
If he's solids, they're solids, right?
Yes. Yeah, you guys are solids. Well, cool, man. I'm glad you're sitting, you know, keeping me company. You know, I really need more of you guys to come and help because... There's a lot of you guys. I don't know you guys.
This is actually my first time, so I'm kind of excited and nervous too. So
yeah, but it really helps because, you know, we want the sport to grow and we want the leagues to grow. So whatever you guys can do to help us call the action and have these players get to know you. Look, all your friends looking at you now.
Hi, San Antonio guys. Over here commentating live on POVpool.com.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Representing the Texas ACS,
yes,
right?
Sir. Yes, yeah, sir. Representing San Antonio as well. Just waiting for a match to finish on table 11. Then I play on table 12 next, but they were heel right now.
Okay.
So we got a good shot there.
So do you like 8-ball? Is this one of your favorite games? Or do you like 9-ball? Or
I prefer playing 8-ball most of the time.
Okay.
More of a challenge also.
Yeah, this is a strategic game, you know?
It's very.
Yeah, how long have you been playing pool, Lewis?
Well, I've been around the table since I was in diapers, so I'm 30, so long time.
You're not still in diapers.
No. I can't be. It'd be kind of embarrassing to be out here trying to change my diaper out here.
Yeah. Maybe when you get older.
Maybe.
That's cool. Well, this is exciting for me. You know, I came in here from California.
Oh, you're from Cali. All
right. So I drove 1,400 miles to come and hang out with you guys.
Oh, wow. That's a long drive.
You
didn't fly?
No, I didn't fly, you know, because I got equipment.
Yeah. You know? So you got to get all your equipment, right?
Got to get the gear here. All right. So looks like this is a good opportunity for John to break out that one ball.
Yeah.
You see the
there we go.
One under the nine? Just got to draw this out.
Ooh. A little firm.
Yeah, a little firm.
It's all right. It doesn't look like there's really much of a shot. I mean, here's a 10 ball, maybe straight in.
Yeah, possibly. The 10 and the 12 look like the same color, don't they?
Yeah. Can't believe the previous game he missed that straight in 8-ball earlier, Dave.
Oh, I know, huh?
After Stacy made that beautiful bang shot, my God.
That was something else. That was special.
Ooh, looks like Stacy got a good shot. Well, leave him to nine.
Kick the nine ball away, yep. This is a one-loss side match, too, isn't it?
Yeah, I think believe so, yeah.
Yeah, it is.
So whoever loses two, I think they're done. Ooh. And you make her arch over that eight ball. It's going to be a tough shot.
Yeah, I know. But, you know, she's also got to get away from the rail.
The rails and all those other balls. Make sure they don't block her. You got the one.
Next.
Yeah. Get that 1, 8, 2, and 6 that could possibly block her any which way.
It's just a small window, so you got to be accurate here. And she's going to be, you know what they say, it's called being tree-topped, right?
Mm-hmm.
She's tree-topped over the eight ball. Half table length. Yeah. Justin Adams in the chat room says, there's the lefty. Did they call your match?
That's my match. That is my match, so.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'll be going.
Lewis,
yes,
hey,
sir.
Thank you. Come visit me again, my friend.
Probably stop by after my match, let you know what happens with the outcome.
Sure thing. Yeah.
Thank you.
Keep us updated. Ask Lewis from San Antonio. He's got a match. Who's your teammate?
Naomi.
Naomi.
Yeah, we play here.
What's your last name?
Her last name?
Your last name.
Olivo.
Olivo. Oh, you're also Olivo. Okay.
Yeah, like I said, it's my husband.
Okay. All right. So we're still in this situation here where, okay, so it looks like she's trying to decide how to approach this shot. She's got a chance to make this 12 ball, or is it the 10? Looks like the 10 ball. I could be wrong though. Maybe it's the 12. But she doesn't want to use the bridge, or she does. Oh, she's using her own bridge head. All right, let's see how she addresses this. This is not an easy shot. Very, very careful. Doesn't want to hit that eight ball with the cue. Oh, no. Scratcho. So here comes Nancy. She's going to take ball in hand. It's always nice to come to the table with ball in hand. Now, I would recommend taking the one ball out. Just like she's set it up here. Because that's kind of the problem ball. It only really has one pocket available. And from what I can tell, I don't really think there's any coaching allowed. Sending the cue ball down table a little bit. So, forcing John to play the six ball. In the side pocket. It goes. And here comes Nancy. cue ball's on the rail here, so shape on the eight's not straightforward here. Okay, this is going to put John to the test. Long shot on the eight. It's a good thing to do, to use your cue as an aiming, sort of like an aiming aid, so that you can see through the contact point of the ball. Gives you something to set your crosshairs on. And look at that. Drilled it. Great shot from John Olivo. High five between these guys. So, whoopsie. Sorry, I just noticed that... I had taken the scoreboard away, so it is now 1-1. We got action, folks. This is a close match so far. It's a race to three from the one loss side, so tournament life is at stake here between these two teams. This is mixed Scotch doubles, if you guys are just joining us. So here comes David Martinez. With the break. Oh! I think the eight counts on the break. Want to commentate with me? Want to do some commentary? Okay, good.
I did it with Kenny Mike one time.
Oh, yeah? It's my man Igor here. He's with Frieder's Billiards. He's walking around raffling cues for the duration of this event. So I want to thank Frieder's Billiards for sponsoring the ACS State Championship and helping to sponsor this live stream. He's taking a little break. So, nice shot by Nancy. Looks like the 13 will go to the corner pocket. All right, so it looks like they're sort of getting through this rack, and most of the balls are open. Okay, bumping the 14 to the middle of the table. That's okay. Either to the side of the corner. Looks like he's shooting at the corner. It goes. Now, I see the 8 balls down over by that 10 ball, so it might be a good idea to save the 10 ball for last. So, fortunate there to get actually shape on both balls. So this is like a draw shot, or if you want to play for the window between the 7 and the 1. Uh-oh. I tell you what, though, that's a good place for the cue ball to land. So Stacy Linerode's going to come to the table with really not much to shoot at. Looks like she might have to play a safety here, which I think would be a wise choice. No point in trying to go for something that's really, really difficult. I don't think that six ball is makeable. Maybe it is if you play it off the 10. I think that's actually possible. If you play that off the 10, you might be able to make that six ball. But can she get enough of the six ball? I don't know. Yeah, it doesn't look like it to me. Yeah, so she's gonna... Uh-oh. Sorry about that. So she's gonna call the 7? Or the 2 to the opposite corner. Okay. Good morning. Good morning in the chat room to everybody out there who is watching. Please feel free to share. Let everybody know we're live today. Dave Martinez. Man, we're tied up at 1-1, so, you know, this is a pretty important game for both teams. I guess every game is important, isn't it? Why do we always say that? This is an important game. Every game's important. Well, I tell you what, seems like Stacy likes to get herself. Well, it looks like her partner is the one who left her over the ball, but maybe that's the thing. David likes to leave her. David likes to leave her tree-topped over other balls. Don't ask me why. I don't know why. But that's just a little pattern I'm noticing. So anyway, she was tree-top before. And she missed the ball. Let's see if she can redeem herself. from the last time. And yeah, that upside down image that you guys see is because I had to actually mount one of our cameras upside down. And so until we can adjust that camera angle, we just have to live with that for now. So it looks like Stacy was just waiting for the opposite table to play through. See how she does. Come on now. You got this. Oh, I don't know if that's a foul. I don't know if they're doing cue ball foul only. Or giving the player option to replace the ball. So Nancy's going to come to the table. So it looks like it's player option. So no foul. Taking a look now at that 10 ball. My goodness. All right. Sorry about that, guys. Is that 10 ball makeable? It is. What a shot. That was clutch. That was a clutch shot. And there you have it. That's going to be 2-1. John Oliva and Nancy Cardenas are on the hill. Once again, we also want to thank Red Tree Jewelry for working with the Texas ACS League this year. Check out redtreejewelry.com. In fact, Red Tree Jewelry is supposed to be here at the venue. They're selling some, they've got great jewelry. And throughout the event, I'm actually going to download some pictures and show you some pictures of their cool stuff. But in the meantime, I will post their link in the chat room and encourage you guys, check out their website. You'll find some pretty cool pieces of jewelry. In fact, they also do jewelry that's kind of pool related. So we want to thank Red Tree Jewelry for sponsoring this year's Texas ACS event. Hello to all you guys in the chat room. Jay Miles, Andrew Murphy, Justin Adams. JVV Chicken 6190. I want to say hello to all you guys and thank you for watching. Please share. Let everybody know that we're streaming live today. This match is over. Oh. One lost side has raced to 2. That's amazing. I had no idea. Wow. Andrew Murphy saying that he inherited his grandfather's old pool cue. Well, you might want to get that to a cue maker and get that appraised. Check out the Billiard Encyclopedia. So it looks like Nancy and John are the victors in this match. Winning 2-1. I can't believe that I missed a game. I thought this was a race to 3, but it turns out it was just a race to 2. So with that, we're going to take a quick break, and I'm going to back up the camera. I'm going to give you guys a master shot of the room. And I have to make a quick phone call, and I'll be joining you later. So thanks for watching us today. POV Pool at POVpool.com. And for more information about the Texas ACS League, be sure to visit acs-texas.net. Posting the link in the chat room right now. Yeah. Hold on just a second.